Hello students, now please be ready to listen to the introduction to the poem The Lake Aljala of Innisfree. The poem is a lyric. It is a musical poem. It explores the poet's longing for the peace and tranquility of Innisfree, a place where he has spent a lot of time as a boy. Innisfree is the name of a place. It is a very quiet place, and that is the reason the poet wants to go there. He had spent his childhood in this place. He has very sweet memories of that place. That is why he wanted to go back to the lake island of Innisfree. The Lake Aljala of Innisfree is a 12-line poem comprising 3 quatrains, written by William Butler Yeats in 1888. And first published in the National Observer in 1890. It was reprinted in the Countess Kathleen and various legends and lyrics in 1892 and as an illustrated Kola Press broadside in 1932. Regarding the poet William Butler Yeats, he was an Irish poet and one of the foremost figures of 20th century literature. A pillar of the Irish literary establishments, he replied to found the Abbey Theatre and in his latter years served 2 terms as a senator of the Irish Free Estate. Dear students, now be ready to listen to the summary of the poem. The poet is reminded of his past, his boyhood, when he visited peaceful place, peaceful lake, Aljala of Innisfree. He wants to go there and says that he will live there all alone. He wants to build a small cabin with clay and wattles. He would grow beans and get a honeybee hive for honey to survive on. The poet describes the peaceful natural surroundings of the lake. He says that the scene of the cloudy mornings, the shining stars, the glowing sun, and birds flying in the sky give him peace. He feels relaxed to hear the pleasant sound of the cricket song. The poet feels the urgency to go to the lake Aljala of Innisfree. In the depth of his heart, he can hear the sound of the lake waters hitting the shore. It is as if the lake is calling him. He hears the sound everywhere, either on the crowded roads or the grey-colored pavements of the city in which he lives. This indicates that he wants to escape from the artificial life of the city into the peaceful surroundings of nature. The poet says that he will go to the island of Innisfree and live there in solitude. Innisfree is a small island in a lake called Lough Zill in Sligo County, Ireland. The poet used to visit this place or island regularly in his childhood. The poet says that there he will build a small cottage with wattles, cultivate beans on a small path, and will also breed honeybees. He says that he would definitely experience peace over there. It is so calm and quiet over there that one can hear the cricket sing, can see the sky full of stars at night, experience the glowing sunlight during the daytime, and hear the melodious song of the linnet bird in the evenings. The poet says that he misses the peace and tranquility of that island so much that he could actually hear the water of the lake lapping on the shores of Innisfree even as he stands on the pavement of the gloomy city. The message that we derive from the poem is that the poet wants to say that sometimes it is necessary to break free. Sometimes it is necessary to break free from the hustle and bustle of modern society and experience the peace of rural areas. It tends to rejuvenate one's body and soul. Now please be ready to listen to the explanation of this poem. The first stanza begins with, "I will arise and go now, and go to Innisfree, and a small cabin built there of clay and wattles made. 9 beans row will I have there, a hive for the honeybee, and live alone in the bee-loved glade." Please pay attention on the new words. Arise means stand up, cabin means room, wattles means twisted sticks for making fences, walls, glade means cleaning open space. Bee loud refers to the sound made by the buzzing of the bees. I hear refers to the poet William Wills. He says that he wants to go to the Innisfree. Over there, he will build a small room for himself with clay and small sticks which are used to make the walls or the fences of the cabin. As he will need some food to eat also, so he will grow 9 rows of beans near his room. Also, he will get the honey from the honeybee hive. He says that the open space where he will build his room will be full of buzzing sound of the bees, and over there he will live alone in peace and tranquility. Then we have the second stanza, "And I shall have some peace there, for peace comes dropping slow, dropping from the wells of the morning to where the cricket sings, their midnights all a glimmer, and noon a purple glow, and evenings full of the linnet's wings." Here are the new words, listen carefully. Wells, a piece of fine material worn by women to protect or hide the face. Cricket is an insect related to the grasshoppers, but with shorter legs. The male produces a characteristic musical chirping sound. Linnet is a small brown and gray bird with a short beak. Glimmer means something which is shining. Now listen to the descriptions of the stanza. In this stanza, the poet says that when in Innisfree, he will feel peaceful. And he says that the feeling of the peace is felt slowly and gradually. He describes how he would feel peaceful in the morning time when it is cloudy and the view is not very clear. Then it will appear as if the morning has worn a veil and has hidden itself. Looking at this scene will make him feel peaceful. Further, he says that when the male cricket insect will sing a song, that sound will bring him at peace. Also, at night when he will see the twinkling stars in the open sky, their sign will give him peace. In the afternoon, when the sunlight will give a purple glow, it will also give him peace. During the evening, when he will see the linnet bird flying in the sky, then also he will feel peaceful. Now we have the third stanza. "I will arise and go now, for always night and day I hear the lake water lapping with low sounds by the shore. While I stand on the roadway or on the pavement's gray, I hear it in the deep heart's core." Night and day means all the time, lapping, that is striking, heart's core, that is the innermost part of the heart. In this stanza, the poet says that now he will stand up and go to the Innistree because all the time the sound of the lake waters striking the shore repeats in his mind. The sound attracts him towards the lake. Wherever he is, either standing on the roadway or on the grey-coloured pavements, he hears the sound deep in the innermost part of his heart. Let us now learn about the literary devices employed in the poem. That is, figures of speech or other kind of literary devices which could have been used in the poem you are likely to learn over here. Okay, now be ready. The first of all, let us learn about the rhyme scheme. Rhyme scheme in the poem is a, ba, a, ba. A, ba, a, ba. Alliteration. Alliteration is the second literary device employed in the poem. The repetition of a consonant sound in two or more closely placed words is called alliteration. The repetition of a consonant sound in two or more closely placed words is called alliteration. That is, the repetition of a consonant sound at a regular or close intervals is known as alliteration. In the poem, the instances of alliteration are first, hive, honeybee. Ha sound is repeated. Lake, lapping, low is the second instance. La sound is repeated. Now we have the another literary device employed, which is repetition. Repeating lines to emphasize certain aspects in the poem or to bring about some beauty or musical melody. In the poem, the line "I will arise and go now" is repeated in stanza 1 and 3. Now we have the next literary device, which is known as personification. In the poem, morning is personified. Personification is the literary device wherein some abstract things or non-living things are given human attributes or human characteristics. Now we have the next literary device in the poem, which is metaphor. Metaphor you are familiar with. In the poem, clouds are compared to whales, so clouds are metaphors for the whales.